Okay, now we're going to learn how to set up your registration for your event with using Google Forms and Google Spreadsheet. Here's a sample of a completed registration form. It's simple, straightforward, easy to use for your guests to fill out. The questions, each one they see, that's with a red mark after it, means that it's a required field, and when they're finished, they hit the submit button. So how do we do one of these forms? Well, we start in Google Drive. Go to Create, select Form, and we're not going to choose a theme right now. First, we're going to start with our form, and the first thing to do is give it a title. So we will call this Corporate Luncheon. Now we can add all the fields that we need for this registration form. One of the most important things about registration forms is knowing what data it is that you want to collect, and remembering that this data that you collect is going to integrate with your spreadsheet. Each thing that you put in your form will become a field in your spreadsheet. So the most common thing that we're going to want to collect, obviously, is the name. And again, if you want to sort by the last name, make sure that you collect both of these as separate fields. So a first name, there's different question types, and in this case, we just want text. And when we're done, this is where they're going to put their answer. When you're done with that, we can select done, and now we need to do their last name. So we add item, and again, the question type will be a text, and we're doing last name. And done. Now let's say the next thing we want to know is what department they're in. So we're going to add an item. What department are you in? This time we don't want them to write it, we want them to have a selection. So what we can do is give them a choice from a drop down menu. And we'll say, give them a few choices. And they'll have to select one when they come to this question. Another thing we can do is use a checkbox. So we can say your meal preference. Sometimes it's good to know if you've always got a vegetarian in the group or someone who's vegan. So we'll do checkbox, and we'll have chicken, meat, let's say beef, or vegetarian. If you've made a mistake, you can always go back and edit your question. And remember, down here, if you select required question, your guests will have to answer that field. Some things like email, last name are usually required, so you make sure you collect that. They will not be able to submit the form unless they've selected all the required, unless they filled out all the required questions. Now, a couple of things we want to do before we look at our spreadsheet. Let's save this form, the same name as our function, so Corporate Luncheon. And now we can view our live form. Now, so we haven't selected a theme, so let's go back and select a theme. Do that right over here, theme. This is a corporate. There's a couple choices. You can scroll through and see what fits you best. Just click on the one you want, select OK. There's no change here, but when you go to View Live Form, you'll see the change and the fields that you want your guests to fill out. The other thing you can do from here is view your responses. And this will link you straight to the spreadsheet. The spreadsheet was automatically created when you create the form. Timestamp is the time that they filled out this form. And as you notice, each field in the form has now become a column in your spreadsheet. This is really handy, like I said, in case you want to sort by their last name or what department they're in. You just have a lot more flexibility when it downloads to a spreadsheet. Again, we need to don't forget to title your spreadsheet, and we'll do We don't have to say it's a spreadsheet because if you've noticed, the logo here changes whether it's a spreadsheet or a form. If we go back and look now in a Google Drive, this logo right here, this icon is for forms and this icon is for spreadsheets. So now we have both of our form and our spreadsheet ready to go and start collecting information. So when we're ready to collect information, we've finished our form and we can say send form. We have two ways to share this. One is to just copy and paste the link. We have a couple ways to share this. One is to simply copy the link and share it with an email. The other is to click your Twitter or your Facebook, link it to those accounts and share it that way. It's a good idea if it's public. Another way is to embed it into your website. Here you copy the code and embed that into your website. And finally, last thing you can do is email. And as you know, this form, all your Google information is connected. So this form, if you click here, you'll be able to access your Google contacts. As soon as you hit send, your guests will receive this form. And there you have it, a real simple way to collect all the information you need from your guests.